He's trying, Pastor Val, to get us out of place, Auntie Ruthie, that we can't navigate. He wants to be our GPS. Hold this up for me. 30-something years, everything that you see around here, one person done it. Everything you see before, they done it. Then the joint there got together, not knowing how this was going to roll out. Mm-hmm. Especially with all these figures on here. We ain't asking for $5. $10,000, $50,000, $30,000. But the Lord used Auntie Ruth to walk on water. I don't know how this is going to happen, but my focus is Jesus. I'm not worried about the what. I'm not worried about the who. And the others that will or won't. But I know I heard the Lord tell me to come. So now, not able to really navigate. We can't navigate this. We don't know if you'll give it up. I'm just saying. But in order to do something we've never done before, we had to get out the boat and walk on water. God told me to do it, so I'm gonna do it.
Lord, what? I said, God, you can come to the keyboard. I'm really done. Robinson. And he said, give me a little faith. Why did you doubt? I've been with you. Taiwan, when we start paying attention to all of the stuff that's going on in our life and know that God has brought us to where we are, even with Him with us, we still will see. Even when we know you wouldn't be where you are right now if it had not been for the Lord.
Yes, sir.
But life has a way. Life and cares of life, sickness and death, trying to make it has a way of taking your eyes off of Jesus. But even if you get to that place, He is still there to pick you up. His goodness is still there for you. They go back into the boat with the rest of the disciples who had just went all the way back. Gets in the boat. And the Bible says that they worship. At the end of all of it, at the end of the day, you know what God wants out of it? Worship. He wants us to give Him the glory. That's what He wants. But we are here. People, hear me today. Some of us are too comfortable. We've been doing the same thing over. We have perfected our averageness.
Wow. You said something, honey.
I remember reading a book called The Enemy Called Average. We perfected that thing. We've done it so. We're good at it, and we pride ourselves on being good at what we're good at. And there's nothing wrong with that. But how long are you going to still be good when God wants to make you great? Yeah. When Noah built the ark, sir, Dr. Corto, he didn't build the ark for himself. The Lord wanted him to build an ark for his family. We got stuff that God wants us to do that's going to benefit others.
That's right. That's right.
When our focus is on the what, it should be on the who. It's still Jesus.
Yes.
It's still Jesus.
Yes. Yes.
In our good, in our bad, in our right, in our wrong, it's still Jesus.
Yes.
Lift your hands, stand to your feet. Read this scripture to you. Colossians 1:15. The Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in Him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible. Whether thrones, or powers, rulers, or authorities, all things have been created through Him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. Lift your hands. It's still Jesus. Don't focus, you can't look. Don't focus on the what. What? Or even the why. Our focus should be on the who. And it's still Jesus. I don't know if there's anybody in here today. And I want to preach long because I wanted to have time to minister to whoever. You can say, listen, you talk about storms. I've been through some stuff. I've been swirling. I've been doubtful. I've been in a place that I just didn't know. I got my focus off of Jesus. If that's you today, and you want me to pray for you, I pray for you this morning that your eyes of understanding will be enlightened. Or you may say, I'm the one who you said, I can do this stuff with my eyes closed. I know that that's greater. I need to get out this phone and walk on water.
Yeah.
If that's you, the altar is open. The altar is open. Papa, can you come up and with us? Honey, can you come up and with us? There's about four more of you. And I don't rush this. There's about four of you. Just you leaving from your seat. It's a faith walk. Hallelujah, Jesus. Two more. There's two more of you. Hallelujah. It can be scary. Being in the middle of water in darkness, that is scary. You can't figure it out. That's an uneasy feeling. But the Lord will say unto you on today, get your focus off what? Whether it's who, what, whatever it may be. And focus back on me. I'm going to navigate you all the time. Hallelujah. As our elders are standing here, Prophet Walker is here. When I ask them to pray for you this morning, whatever the need is, whatever that is, you may get a prophetic word. You may get the word of wisdom. You may receive the word of knowledge. Open yourself up before they come. Open yourself up to the Lord. I need you to focus. Open yourself up. Open yourself up. Say, God, whatever you want to do, whatever you want to do, I'm out here now. You got out the boat. Praise God. You just got out of your comfort zone. Some of you would have never come up to the altar, but you step out on faith with the measure of faith that God has given. You just add to your measure of faith.
open yourself up for the word to be released unto you. These are men of God who are faith prophets who can speak in your life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, I gotta say, it's still a resistance. Let it all go.
Yes,
let it all go. Let it all go. If you have to close your eyes and lift your hands, close your eyes and lift your hands and focus on Jesus. Your focus is 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 on Jesus.
Oh, no.
knock, you will knock. We break it, we break it, break it.
Jesus. Oh, God.
time, I want you to stand right here and sit right there for me. I'm going to stand over right on the other side.
Your focus will get back on him.
If you would lock, I say this to you, if you would lock in this house,
yeah.